Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today.
Welcome to End of the Line. I'm Jim Anderton, Multimedia Content Director at engineering.com, and today we're live at the RAPID+TCT event in Detroit, Michigan. This is 3D printing, additive manufacturing. In this case, I'm at the EOS booth, looking at some additively manufactured parts, which are sort of typical of the state of the art of this industry. This is a Formula One brake pedal, highly skeletonized, very, very lightweight, almost imperceptible weight in this part, in light alloy. This part, an aerospace heat exchanger, and almost impossible to render or even imagine shape with a very, very complex internal cooling channels inside. And of course, this very, very large rocket engine built by Launcher for space applications. These applications are typical of what we're seeing now in additive manufacturing, and that is shapes that cannot be imagined or rendered or built any other way except by additive. Now, if there's one thing that I've noticed walking this show floor during this event, is that we're moving to a place now where it is not humanly possible, I believe, to design to optimize parts for additive manufacturing. I think we're looking at a world in which we're gonna have to either simulate and iterate our way to better designs, or use some kind of AI or generative design system to actually create the shapes necessary to do this. I seriously doubt that it's going to be possible for a human being to take conventional subtractive manufacturing concepts and ideas on the design phase and then additively optimize a part, at least using technology like this. This is exciting stuff. I mean, we're seeing technologies in aerospace, technologies in surgically implantable materials, in sporting goods, some wild things at this show, right down to things like movie props. This world is changing rapidly. And the interesting thing about this industry as I see it right now is that there is consolidation going on. So we're seeing some large firms like this one that produce production-ready machines and equipment that can sort of drop in the way a CNC machine tool can. But we're also still seeing the startups. You're seeing sort of the garage operations that come up with something interesting, especially in the software space. They're exhibiting here too, sort of around the periphery of the building. So this is a world where additive manufacturing has been around for 20 years, but still has a bit of a ground floor feel to it. It's still a place where innovators can come in early, make some noise and do something, then either be acquired by one of the big ones, or conversely, carve out a niche or a space in the industry and make a lot of money and develop a lot of interesting things. It's very exciting. If you're a young person today and you're involved in engineering in any way, I would suggest coming to a show like this and taking a look at advanced additive manufacturing, because there are things going on here that transcend conventional engineering. It almost moves into the art space. And the arts, in fact, I think in the future are going to be another major consumer of additive technology. It's really exciting stuff. Additive manufacturing, 3D printing, the names are used synonymously, but really, this I think is the future of manufacturing.
Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by engineering.com. If you like this show, be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell for our next episode. For our deeper engineering video series for the manufacturing professional, visit engineering.com TV to watch exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, not found here on our YouTube channel. The link is in the description below. Thanks for watching.